waiting for the opening of the Canadian Museum of Human Rights. I'm very honored to have with us His Excellency, the Governor General of Canada, the Right Honorable Mayor Johnson. Nice to have you here.
Great to be here on this wonderful day.
Let's talk a little bit about this museum. First impressions when you walk through the door.
Stunning. But I was here just as it was in the early stages of building and saw the avenues winding up and saw the concept of the Tower of Hope at the top. And I thought the architectural vision was remarkable, and I think it's a stunning accomplishment and a great tribute to the people of Winnipeg and Manitoba.
Yes, no question. You've had a little bit of time to look at some of the galleries. Was there one particular moment or one particular story that touched you?
Well, we spent some time earlier this morning in the Aboriginal Gallery, and I was so struck by the stories that have come down over the years and the centuries, which reminds us that human rights, of course, has been an endless challenge and struggle, and how important it is that Canada be a leader in this area of endeavor.
We found often people who get the sneak peek that you got have a surprisingly emotional response to the museum. Can you talk a little bit about your feelings as you toured?
Well, my sense was how anxious I was that my grandchildren come and see this. There are 11 of them, and how important it is for children at an early age to come to understand that the respect for human rights is something that we don't and shouldn't take for granted. It just doesn't happen. In fact, it's a very thin veneer of civilization, and we all must work at building it, protecting it, strengthening it. And this museum will do so much to do that. So my orientation is very much the world that my children and my grandchildren will live in, and how we want future generations to live, and what an important part of the development of our civilized society is played by a museum like this in creating that thicker veneer of civilization.
That's an excellent way to put it. You're, of course, the Queen's representative here in Canada. Does Her Majesty have any thoughts about the museum?
Well, she's very lively interested in this. In fact, I'll be giving a message from Her Majesty shortly as we do the opening. And as you know, she was here at the beginning with a stone from Runnymede, 1215 Magna Carta, which really marked the beginning of the evolution of constitutional monarchy with responsible government and the protection of human rights in what we would call the British Commonwealth today. And we, of course, in Canada are the lucky inheritors of that great tradition that comes down from Runnymede, 1215, Magna Carta, and the Queen focused on that specifically.
Can we begin holding our breath, expecting a visit now that the doors are opening?
Well, she will certainly have a great interest, and you can certainly expect that various members of the royal family will want to come here and see what happened from the time that stone from Runnymede was laid here some years ago.
Well, we're very, of course, very pleased and very proud that this museum is here in Winnipeg. It's the first one to be built outside of Ottawa, and I'm wondering, as a citizen of Ottawa, what your Ottawa friends think of us getting one away.
Well, I'll tell you what they should think of it. They should be thrilled. You know, this is such an important part of the Canadian experiment, and one wants to be sure that we see this distributed country of ours with different communities doing outstanding things, and it's no surprise that Winnipeg is Manitoba once again doing an outstanding thing, which is putting a spotlight on a subject as important as human rights. So the folks of Ottawa should celebrate and rejoice.
Just the folks of Winnipeg are. Thank you so much for your time today.
Great to be with you,
Jeremy.
Thank you.